Hi everyone, welcome back to another Placeit tutorial. In today's video, I'm going to be walking you through how to create a video mockup from scratch. If you haven't heard of a video mockup before, or you haven't created one, these are examples of what they look like, and essentially you can Photoshop your t-shirt design or your mug design, a number of different items, onto actual videos of that product. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started with this tutorial. So first things first, if you are new to Placeit.net, it is a paid service. So you are going to need a subscription to use these tools. However, I will put my affiliate link down in the description. It's essentially my referral link over to Placeit, but the benefit is it gives you 15% off any of their paid plans. So with that being said, you can use that link down in the description and it'll bring you right to this homepage here with the discount built in. Now, once you're all set and ready to go, all we have to do is hover over mockups, and then scroll down to apparel videos and click on that. These are going to be all of the apparel video templates that Placeit has to choose from. If you scroll to the bottom, you'll be able to see that as of right now, they have 35 different pages of these apparel videos, but Placeit is always adding new templates, so I wouldn't be surprised if by the time you're watching this, there are more pages to choose from. So for the sake of really making this helpful for you guys, instead of just going straight into these and starting to edit them, I'm going to really quickly, in under a minute, create a brand new t-shirt design on Placeit, and we'll use that for this tutorial. So let's go ahead and do that right now. I'm just going to hover over designs, and then I'm going to go to t-shirt designs and click on that. Now these are all their t-shirt design templates. They have pages upon pages of these, but I'm just going to click one of these. This is actually a really cool looking design. Now, obviously, if you were creating this t-shirt design for yourself, you would want to customize this and change all the text. If you need a video on that, I'll link it up in the corner, and that'll walk you through what all these buttons do and how to make really awesome designs. But the most important thing, I'm just going to change the background color to transparent. This way we can put it on any color product or shirt when we create our mockups, and then I'm just going to click download. Now let's just give this 1 second to process here, and our download is ready to go. All right, so we've got our t-shirt design. This is the one that I'm going to use for our video mockup. So let's just go back to Placeit, hover over mockups, go to apparel videos. And now the next step is to find a video that fits your brand or the purpose that you're creating this mockup for. Now there's a few different type of apparel mockups. One is going to be your standard video. So this is a selfie style video, but it's a real 30 frame per second video. Now another type of video mockup that you'll find is something like this, where it's a product with a graphic background. One of the newer types of mockups they've created, which are pretty cool, are these parallax style videos, where the person or the product is still and then the background is zooming in. It just gives a nice attention-grabbing touch if you're using that for social media. And then the last main type of mockup video that you're going to find is something like this, where it's a series of different photos. Now, all of these are very attention-grabbing, as you can see. That's what makes these mockup videos really cool, but just wanted you to be aware that there are different styles. So I'm just going to create a standard mockup here. It's going to be a selfie style, just a standard 30 frame per second video. All right, just like that, we're already into the editor and now let's start getting to it. So over on the left side is where we're going to click to insert that image or that t-shirt design that we just created. Now once you click insert image, you're going to have two options: upload from your device. This is if the file or the design is saved on your computer, or import from downloads, which is going to be your downloads up in the corner here. So if there are t-shirt designs that you made on Placeit, but you don't know exactly where they are on your computer or you can't find them quickly, you can just click import from downloads and it's essentially going to allow you to browse through all of the downloads or previous designs that you've made on Placeit. All right, once you select your design, you'll be able to crop it. And this is one of the more important parts here. You wanna make sure that your design is somewhere up in the chest area of the shirt. Now, obviously, if you're creating a mug as opposed to a t-shirt, then you'll wanna play with this and find the right spot. Now don't worry, once you hit crop here, it's going to process it and show you what it looks like. If it doesn't look like it's in the right spot on the shirt or on the product, then you can easily go over here and click resize and you can adjust it and hit crop again. So to me, looking at this, I can see from the preview, it looks like it is in the right spot, so we won't have to change anything here. All right, we can click X on this preview and we can click update slide. All right, and just like that, you can see that our t-shirt design is actually on this video. And Photoshopped on, you can't even tell that this was created with software. So moving on to a couple other features that we have here. This is down at the bottom. You can play all of your slides. You can add in other slides. I'll show you what this looks like, but I don't typically use it. This is adding in another 5 or 10 seconds of a different video. Not something I typically use, but if you are interested in that, that's how this feature works. And the last couple things on the right here are to add an audio track, which you can open up and you can actually select from copyright-free music that you can put in the background of this video. Now you can preview the songs by hitting the play button here. You can star them for saved tracks so you can find them easier in the future. And if you find one that you'd like to use, you can just hit select and it'll add it right to your video. And the last thing to be aware of is you can change the shirt color. So if you want to change this to any different color, all you have to do is click it. It'll show you what it looks like in the preview. And if you like that, you can just click off, click X, and once you click update slide, it'll change that to the new color. Now, a couple more quick but important things to know here is when you're selecting your color, if you have a specific color you need to use for your brand, you can hit this more button here, and you can either select it in here by changing these sliders, or you can enter the number to that color right here. And lastly, I would make as many changes as you can before hitting the update slide button because it does take 10 to 15 seconds for it to process your changes. So just for the sake of saving time, that may be a way to make it a little bit more efficient for you. All right, now that everything looks good, we're just going to hit the play all button one time. It asks us to watch the entire video that we're creating before we can hit the download button, just in the event that you had added extra slides and you weren't aware of them. So just make sure that you hit the play all button down here. And now you can proof your video. If you see anything that you need to change before hitting the download button, you can just hit X, it'll bring you right back to the editor. You can make those changes and then hit play all again. So since we only had this one video right here, it's 10 seconds, everything looks great. I'm just going to go ahead and hit download. Now, just like when we were creating the t-shirt designs, the pop-up will come up in the corner, letting you know that they're processing the video mockup. All right, and just like that, we can click here to download our video mockup. And this will download directly to your computer. And once it's ready to go, you can just click to open it up. And now we've got ourselves this completed mockup video. All in the matter of minutes we made this, and we didn't have to hire a model, send them a shirt, and all of the usual costs that are associated with creating these types of videos. Just remember, if you do have a subscription to Placeit, it's about $15 per month, but if you use the link down in the description, it comes down to about $12.70 per month. That gets you unlimited downloads of all of their different templates. So depending on how much you plan to use this software, it can be a huge bang for your buck. So guys, hopefully this has helped you in creating a video mockup. That's all for this video. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comments. I'd be happy to help you out. Otherwise, I will see you all in the next Placeit tutorial.